As the world looks to Philadelphia to celebrate the collection of Albert and Laura Barnes, we also want to celebrate their appreciation for the art form of gardening. While Albert Barnes was assembling his paintings and other pieces of art in the 1920s and 30s, his wife Laura Barnes was responsible for developing the garden. As the visual arts were the passion of Dr. Barnes, so horticulture was the passion of his wife. The 12-acre arboretum was Laura's living landscape, her ever-changing art gallery. She recognized that gardening uses the trunks and stems of trees and shrubs to create structure, forms and shapes of leaves and needles to evoke texture, and that bursts of blooms and berries create pops of color in the garden. All these elements combine to paint the canvas of the garden. The Scott Arboretum of Swarthmore College, in concert with the Greater Philadelphia Gardens and with Art Philadelphia, wants to celebrate Garden as Art with a series of videos depicting five of our most artful gardens. Glimpse how plants create structure, color, and texture in our painting of the landscape.
Hi, we're in the Metasequoia Allee at the Scott Arboretum, the campus of Swarthmore College. And while we have a number of distinct artful gardens that are a part of the campus, this one has a unique personality as an allee, meaning a formal tree-lined walkway. The name of this area is called the Metasequoia Allee, and so on either side of the path you're now seeing Metasequoias in their winter, early spring character. These are now over a decade old. It's a very fast-growing deciduous conifer, so it drops its needles in the fall and gives us this wonderful silhouette in the wintertime, creating a formal row and a sense of enclosure as students and visitors to the arboretum walk up and down this path. So the focus is on the trunk of these trees, which will get more sculptural as time goes on. And because we wanted the focus to be on the trunks, we're keeping a very simple color scheme to the ground plane and the shrub plane. So I'm holding some representatives of that in my hand. We decided that everything underneath the Metasequoias would be white in some fashion, whether it's their flowers. So now we have a couple of early spring bulbs in bloom, a white form of Kynodoxa. All of the snowdrops are just about over, but here are a few remnants of that. So this creates white sheets in March.
Another expression of white in the Metasequoia Allee comes from the variegated foliage of this arum with these arrow-shaped leaves. So it has a mottled white pattern in the foliage, which carries through with that white theme. An example of a white flowering shrub, this is Hydrangea arborescens, one of our native shrubs,
which has white flowers in the summertime, and this is the dried flower head from that. So, Metasequoia Allee featuring a formal row of trees and a ground cover of white blooming or white variegated plants.